Which operating system should you use as a software engineer or tester? Should you use Mac, Windows, or probably Linux? I will tell you everything you need to know about that. First and foremost, quite often, as a professional developer, you don't have the luxury of actually choosing the operating system that you are going to work with. Your company will provide you with a laptop, which will have operating system pre-installed. And even if it's not the case, in many other cases, the choice has been made for you as well. For example, if you're working as a Windows-specific or MacOS-specific software developer, you will most likely use those operating systems. But what if you are a web developer or backend developer and you can actually choose an operating system for yourself? Or probably you're just learning how to do software development? Well, in this series, I did my best to assemble Windows, Mac and Linux benefits and drawbacks, as well as their related infrastructure. So, let's start with the elephant in the room, Windows operating system. It is definitely the most popular operating system out there, and there are very good chances that you had worked with it as a user. Would it make sense to use it as a developer? In fact, it may be actually a very good option for you. As I already mentioned, Windows is the most popular operating system, which puts you in a very good place if you need some support. Besides, you might be even eligible for Microsoft support in some cases. And of course, there are lots of blogs, YouTube videos and posts on the internet explaining all ins and outs of Windows, so with some right effort, it can be a very productive setup. Second, it is the most popular operating system. In fact, more than 75% of all desktop computers are powered by Windows, and therefore, it has the biggest choice of available software. Pretty much everything would have a Windows version, and because of that, Windows is a gamer heaven. Most games would be optimized for working with Windows. So if you want to use a single operating system both for work and gaming, Windows is your guy. Third, Windows comes with WSL. WSL stands for Windows System for Linux, and it's essentially a built-in Linux virtual machine, which comes completely out of the box and works exceptionally well. So, if you're not a Linux type of person and you need to use Unix-like systems only for work activities, such as deploying or debugging something in Bash, Windows gives you those capabilities for free. Fourth, and that was a shock for me as well, in many cases, Windows would also be the fastest operating systems among all three on the same hardware. This is mostly because most of the hardware producers, including CPU and GPU manufacturers, are optimizing their hardware for Windows. Fifth, usually you don't need to do anything to have Windows installed, as it comes pre-installed with most of the laptops and computers on the market. And don't be misled by the home version label of the pre-installed Windows, it's more than capable to do things. Okay, so are there any drawbacks in using Windows? And indeed, there are. So let's start with the most annoying, at least for me, which is computer viruses. While computer viruses are not only limited to Windows, most of the viruses out there are targeting Windows users because Windows is the most popular operating system by far. Criminals don't really care what OS you use, but they do care about making it easier to attack more users, and that's why targeting Windows is a viable strategy. There are some ways to significantly decrease your risk by installing a good antivirus software and doing some tweaks with Windows itself, but it's still extremely annoying. Despite Windows having almost no issues with different kinds of software, some of the software which you as a software engineer or tester might be interested in is particularly painful in Windows. For example, Ruby infrastructure is almost non-existent in Windows, and getting a specific JDK version might be quite painful. It's not that you could just go to the official website and download it. To some extent, this can be mitigated by sticking to WSL only and using Ruby or JDK only under Linux VM, but still, it's very annoying. There were also some concerns about privacy and telemetry in Windows. I'm not myself a security specialist, but apparently, Windows does lock more than it probably should. That being said, it never stopped me from using Windows, so take this with a pinch of salt. And finally, Windows updates is a pure evil. It's almost like they made them annoying on purpose. To the best of my knowledge, updates are impossible to disable fully, and they usually start at the least convenient time, like when I had to rush to the airport and my laptop would decide to install updates at this very minute. asking me not to power off my laptop, not to mention several occasions when the updates would actually break the system or even corrupt user data. That's not okay, Microsoft. So, all things considered, unless you know specifically why you need Mac or Linux computer, Windows might be the best option for you. I want to start with what I think makes Mac the most popular operating system among developers, which is Apple brand. Apple has a very strong brand of being able to produce high-end devices. It is almost as if it's Mac, it has to be good. While Windows devices could be anywhere in the range of piece of the art to the complete garbage. Mac laptops look stylish and many other manufacturers are actually trying to copy their design. In contrast to Windows, Mac is actually a proper Unix operating system. Why it's important? Most of the service software use Unix-like or Unix operating systems, so having experience working with Unix on a daily basis could give you an upper hand when it would come to interacting with servers. Just in case you didn't know, some time ago Apple started to use their own CPUs for some of their laptops, which is called M1. M1 comes with quite a few benefits, among which I would say battery and cooling performance are the most prominent. Battery can work for hours and hours, providing you with very good portability. So, if let's say you need to work in some of the older trains which don't have power socket, you may have chance to work for longer. I also wasn't able to load my M1 Mac enough for it to start to noticeably heat. Now, going to some less strong benefits, which are still often mentioned when people discuss Apple laptops. Mac laptops have very good displays, there is no doubt about that. Some people would say it's a major benefit, but from a professional developer standpoint, you're quite likely to have more than one external monitor, so that is not a strong benefit from my point of view. Mac also comes with some nice programs available for free. That being said, those are usually there for a reason, so you would use them and it would be painful for you to switch to another OS even temporarily. Everything comes with a price, really. Let's start with what annoys me the most. Despite being considered the best laptop for developers by the vast majority of people, without tweaks and additional configuration, Mac is pretty much unusable. There are dozens of different guides how one should tweak the brand new Mac so it becomes actually usable. Linux and Windows will also occasionally have to be tweaked, but it is order of magnitude worse on Mac. Now, you pay some extra bucks for Mac and you expect this to be flawless, right? Wrong. In my personal experience, the overall bugs and errors density is lower on Windows, and while it is higher on Linux comparing to Mac, Linux isn't cost a thing, while Mac cost a lot. So I'd say the overall quality of Mac is not that great if you take price into account. Alright, what next? Apple is quite aggressive with their marketing and they do whatever they can to create a vendor lock. What is vendor lock? Essentially, they do whatever they can to tie users to Apple. Want smartphone integration? It has to be iPhone. Want to use iMovie or GarageBand? Only works on Macs. Even to use the bloody Mac itself, you will be asked to create Apple account and provide your credit card. I mean, bro, seriously? Remember that I mentioned that M1 Mac laptops were good when it comes to battery and temperature? Well, Intel-based are almost completely the opposite. Brand new top MacBook Pro that I had was heating so much, so I could actually turn off the heater in my room, and battery would be flat in a couple of hours, which was actually worse than my 3-year-old Asus ZenBook could do at the time. So you would just use M1 Mac, right? Wrong! Lots of programmer-specific software has issues with M1. For example, the popular Java build system Gradle doesn't work well with M1 in some pretty basic scenarios. Finally, people tend to think that there are no viruses for Mac, but that's not true. There are viruses for Mac, and while there are not many of them, they are still pretty dangerous. And actually, they may be even more difficult to get rid of, as there is not that much knowledge of how to actually fight Mac viruses. Thank you. It's now time for a final video in the Best Operating System for Programmer and Tester series. And today we will find out all pros and cons of using Linux. Let's start with one of the reasons people like me started to use Linux in the first place. Linux is completely free. Free as a free beer. You just go to a website, download the distribution and configure an installation USB stick and install the system. No small print, no hidden agenda, just take and use it. Now, something which is extremely important for a tester or programmer, most likely the target platform for the software you're working on is Linux. It gives you a lot of benefits. It's like Mac is Unix but better, because you get a real possibility to work with the software in the environment it's supposed to run. You learn how to use command line, you learn how to debug and how to configure your application server, all while just using your operating system. And what makes Linux so much better than Mac for me? In contrast to Mac, where sometimes even changing UI font is close to impossible, you can tweak, adjust and configure everything in Linux. This comes with a price, of course, as you can also break the system entirely, but for a programmer or tester, I would say it's rather a good thing. Building and breaking things is our job, isn't it? And in contrast to Mac, many Linux distributions, such as Ubuntu which I use, are common keystones of free software and work quite nice out of the box. You will have to tweak things here and there, of course, but it's way better than Mac configuration pane. And because Linux is often used as a second operating system, Linux actually works quite nice alongside Windows. With Mac you could use Windows Virtual Machine, that's true, but that's not the same. In typical setup you will just configure dual boot and have fully functioning Windows and Linux on the same computer, and Linux will have access to all your Windows data if needed. So what about drawbacks of Linux? Again, I'm starting with the most annoying from my point of view. Sometimes you come across some issue which would be really hard to solve on Linux. For example, let's take my computer. Sometimes Pulse Audio, which is a software responsible for audio configuration on Linux, just fails to work properly, and I randomly cannot use either headphones or laptop speakers. I spent many hours going through blogs and different solutions, but nothing seemed to work. And while you usually don't see any major issues like this one, small bugs and inconsistencies are everywhere. Of course, it's expected for an operating system which is developed by thousands of independent developers. Frankly, the quality that they could achieve is actually surprisingly good, but still, you have to be prepared for it. And on the same note, because Linux is rarely in minds of hardware developers, particular hardware support on Linux may be either incomplete, lagging behind or completely non-existent. So, if you want to use Linux, I suggest googling for some Linux success stories or support information for your particular hardware. Obviously, Linux has far less proprietary software and games available, which is important for gamer, but honestly almost unnoticeable for developer or tester. So, that's it! Now you know all pros and cons of Windows, Mac and Linux when it comes to software programming and testing. Did I miss anything? If so, please drop me a comment and don't forget to subscribe and like this video.